Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I'm gonna answer a question that we actually got at the Microsoft Fabric Community Conference 2025 in Las Vegas. We did a meet and greet, and someone came up in the line and just said, it would be really great if you had a video on how to create a fabric capacity. So enough of all this talking, you know, we like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. All right, so we begin our journey here in the Azure portal. You may be like, why the Azure portal? We're creating a fabric capacity. That's because it's an Azure resource now. First thing that you need to make sure is that you're actually in the tenant or directory that your fabric instance is in. And so in this case, I'm in Guy in a Cube, which is great. If this isn't it, then you can go ahead and click on switch directory and go to the one that you're in. The other thing you need to have is you need to have a subscription. Azure resources are bound to a given subscription. It can be a pay-as-you-go subscription, an agreement subscription. Just make sure that you have one that you can create resources on. Next, to keep this clean, I'm just going to go ahead and start off like we're just kind of fresh. So let's go ahead and create a resource group. I have a couple of resource groups already, but we'll create one for this purpose. So here's where you would select the subscription you want to create this against. I'll create the resource group. Let's do video demo, and then you pick the region that you want. So in this case, I'm going to align the region of the resource group and the capacity itself with what's called my home region for Fabric. And that's the main data region by default that Fabric will go to. You can create capacities in other regions, but for this purpose, I'm just going to stick with the home region. You may ask, how do I verify what my home region is? So if you go to Fabric, we can just go check this real quick. We'll go to the question mark. We'll say about Fabric. And here you will see your data stored in this case, West US, California. That is my home region. So we'll make sure it's West US. Yep. Create the resource group. This is pretty quick. And we'll go into our resource group, and then we can create a resource. Just know that if you don't own the subscription or you're not like a contributor of the subscription, you may not be able to create resources against that subscription. So you'd have to go talk to whoever the owner of the subscription is to figure out what that process is to get you that access, or have them create the resource for you. All right, so we'll hit create, and then we'll do Fabric. And then look there, Microsoft Fabric. We're creating Microsoft Fabric. Just the capacity. All right, so here again, we're gonna align to a subscription that this will be built against, and then the resource group that we wanna create it in. And then here we can give it a name. So let's just do video capacity. Now again, you can select the region that you want the capacity in. Again, we're gonna stick with West US. And then here you can change the size. You know, we've got all the different SKUs that are available. So the F64 SKU, if you were using premium capacities, is equivalent to a P1. And so you can select what you want. If you're just getting started and you wanna kick the tires, F2 capacity is great. So we'll go ahead and select that. You can list out your capacity administrators. So then let's go ahead and review and create. And then you can verify the items below, and then we'll go ahead and create. And this takes a second or two. All right, our deployment is complete. So that's it. You've got your fabric capacity, but wait, that's not it. All right, so this is it from the Azure portal perspective, although we can go back in and we can go look in our resource group, and we'll see that this capacity is there. If we go in, we can also see the capacity is active, meaning it's running, and you can also verify the SKU that you have. In this case, I have an F2. So this is about most of what you're going to do in the Azure portal. The rest of our journey is going to be over in the Fabric portal, so let's cut over to Fabric. And one thing we'll do here is if we go to the gear and then we come down to admin portal under capacities, then we go to Fabric capacity. You'll see that I've actually got a couple of fabric capacities that are here, but three of them are grayed out, and then one of them is showing active. So basically the other three, those are paused in the Azure portal. If I'm on the pay as you go plan, I'm not getting billed while they're paused. So in my case, it's great for doing demos. And then for other folks, if you've got like a dev environment and you're only doing it during the day, that's great to pause it after hours when you're not using it, save some money. So let's go back and we'll pause the video capacity, come back into the Fabric portal, and we'll see now that video capacity is showing paused as well. So let's go ahead and turn it back on. Showing active again, refresh. All right, and then we got our video capacity. It's on, and now I can come in and do things with it. So I can say, let's add Patrick, and then we'll add Martha. So now they are admin permissions, and then contributor permissions. I can just say, look, in my case, everyone can go ahead and use this capacity for their workspaces. And then you can go through the other options that are here, like surge protection, things of that nature. That's just normal capacity settings pieces. So now if we come into workspaces, let's create a new workspace, call the workspace capacity video, because I'm great at naming things. We'll come down, we'll contact list, and then we can go see, now we can choose fabric capacity, and we'll see this capacity capacities in the list. You're only going to see capacities in this list that are active. So if you pause the capacity or you don't have contributor access, you won't see those capacities listed here. And or I can choose trial or premium capacity, whatever. But there we go. We can start creating items against that capacity. Just a couple clicks. You've got to go to two different places initially. But once it's created and it's running, you just live over in Fabric and life is good. Let me know down in the comments what you think. Did this help you? There's also some cool things you can do from an automation perspective to get this going as well. So let me know all your tips and tricks down in the comments. As always, from both Patrick, Martha, and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.